Chemicals used to extinguish or retard fires can be applied from the ground or air. Here's some useful information when you apply them from the ground. Fire chemicals applied from ground equipment are primarily foams and water enhancers. Foams and water enhancers have no chemical retarding effects. Instead, it's their water that extinguishes the fire. We're just using it in a different form. But be careful when you apply it. If applied improperly, water enhancers and foams can form a barrier over the tops of fuels, preventing the fire chemical from penetrating the fuel and allowing the fire to burn underneath and through the line. Also, be careful when using any type of fire chemical on a historical or archaeological site. The chemicals can stain surfaces or result in destructive drying of old wood. As such, chemical residue should be removed soon after the fire passes. In short, consider treating surrounding fuels with chemicals, but carefully weigh all options for protecting the structure or site itself. Mixing chemicals with water usually takes place on the ground. Here are some things to consider when you do. Water enhancers can be sensitive to water quality. Very hard water or salt water will give much runnier consistencies than the same mix ratio in softer or purer water. Also, foams mixed with hard or salt water may show decreased wetting and foaming ability. Water quality may affect the viscosity or fluidity of retardants if they're stored for an extended period of time, that is, over a few days, but the retarding effectiveness should not be affected. In batch mixing, stir the concentrate thoroughly before adding to water, and with foam concentrates, stir gently to avoid excessive foaming. This does not apply, however, when you use a foam or water enhancer proportioner. Never mix different brands of the same product type, for instance, two different brands of Class A foam. Similarly, don't mix foams, water enhancers, or retardants with each other. Last, be aware that foam solutions stored over a period of time in metal tanks may show a decrease in foaming and wetting ability. As important to fighting fires as the chemicals themselves is the equipment used to apply them. Ground firefighters may batch mix chemicals for use in hose lays and spread their fire chemicals through engines, backpack pumps, or other types of portable pumping equipment. Backpack pumps are used in direct attack and mop-up. They are most commonly used to deliver foam solutions or water to the fire. The application technique for foam solutions is the same as it is for water, except that the quantity required for the given task may be less. There are companies who offer attachments for small portable pumps. Others offer backpack-style applicators that are self-contained, and other backpack units that hold the concentrate in the pack and attach to the hose lay. Still other companies offer handheld applicators for delivering foam. You can find information on different types of equipment for mixing and application of various chemicals, including water, in the NWCG publication Water Handling Equipment Guide. There is also a wide variety of commercially available equipment. Just remember that only approved fire chemicals may be used in any type of equipment. The USDA and U.S. Forest Service have produced a series of videos that discuss wildland fire chemicals in more depth. We hope you'll view each one to learn more about these important topics. You can also find more details on the Wildland Fire Chemical Systems website. Here you'll find information on safety, environmental issues, product quality, mixing ratios, aerial delivery systems, and other topics related to knowing when and how to use wildland fire chemicals.